what's going on, guys? Welcome to Nasia. I bet you've been waiting for this one, cooking episode. I haven't done one in almost over a year. So, yeah. I thought, well, I could hit off with homemade pizza. Now, the first step to homemade pizza is your dough. And this is some dough I made last night. It's been fermenting in the fridge for about 12 hours, I'd say. I prefer to do it this way. You can't just cover it clean film and leave it at room temperature in one place for an hour or two. But with co-fermenting, it'll proof slower, but you also get a small flavour. That's a little tip for you. So yeah, this is my dough. It's a typical dough recipe. Just pull up yeast. Just get up a dough recipe. Use the first one you find. So yeah. Then, with this one, I always put cornmeal. There's two versions of pizza I do. I do a New York style pizza, not proper New York, because I don't have the actual whole milk or Mr. Mozzarella that they use. I just got a bag of mozzarella. But with Neapolitan, it's just fresh mozzarella. That's the biggest difference between the two pizzas. So yeah, for this one, I use cornmeal. But with a Neapolitan pizza, I use semolina. So with cornmeal, I just sprinkle some on this baking tray. I get a little shake just to make sure I get nice even just to be sure. Then I take the dough out of the bowl, the ball out of the bowl, if that makes sense. Now you see how big that is, that's what you get from proving it for slower in a fridge. So yeah, you got that, it feels nice. Then you do is you get your knife and you just cut it in half. Don't have to be precise with cutting it off, but still cutting it off. Also, you roll the bowl so it doesn't stick to it. Then you get it out. Tear some of it if it's not fully. Yeah.
Then yeah.
Roll it back into a bowl again. Doesn't have to be like a perfect bowl, but just something you could put on the tray without, you know.
That on there.
Yeah, cornmeal onto it. Obviously, don't want to make the bowl too big. Cover that. Then you get the other one and do the same thing. And this will help get the air out of it as well, so it doesn't fluff up in your oven. So yeah, those are two. There's some cling film, just to stop it from drying out. So, you do the overnight method first, and then the second proof is to make sure it doesn't dry out. So like that. Now you let this proof for about 2 hours. The first proof just develops the flavour of the dough, and the second one is just to get it ready for the baking. That's how I do my dough, and I'll come back to you when it's about 6 o'clock, because it's 4 o'clock now, 2 hours, about 6-ish. You can do it for 1 or 1.5, doesn't really matter, but I prefer the 2. I'll come back. It's usually just when I'm hungry that I put the pizza in, so yeah. I'll do that, we'll put the sauce on, then the cheese, and I'll get back to you. It's been about an hour, I'm hungry now, so let's bake a pizza. Just get my dough out. So my dough is nice and proofed. Now I'm just gonna pretty much cut this in flour so it doesn't stick to the screen I'm using, which is over here. Right, so it's got flour. Do it on both sides.
Then I go to the corn.
Which is over here. And then I just fry it out from there.
When the moon
is bright like a pizza pie, and I promise in this song, then I go the back stretch.
Then back down again. Back with an apple stretch. stick to it. Then you just stretch it out with your hand.
But that's easily fixed by doing a little process where you just tear a bit of the other side and then stick it where the hole is.
Brava. That'll do it. Stretch it out a bit more. Then take your finger and
that's my finger, just go around the edge a bit. Like that. Now I got my pizza sauce. It's nothing special, it's just I get some peeled plum tomatoes, then I blend them into a smooth mixture. I like a smooth sauce. Then a pinch of sugar, clove of olive oil, a lot of dried oregano, and then I put about 2 or 3 tablespoons of tomato puree in here. For the Americans, that's a tomato paste. Then I just spread it out from the middle with this ladle.
Just like so. I'll tell you, I love making this
pizza. It's fantastic. It's cheap, easy, and it will be delicious in the end. Now you're thinking, is this all really worth it? Why don't you just get a pizza base and then put your toppings on it? You can do that, but it won't taste anything like the dough I've made. Because homemade is better in my opinion.
And it's easier.
Now some may argue that, but it's my opinion. Now, just press in a single thing. Then you get your cheese. First layer is a parmesan layer. So I just start to now you don't need too much tomato on your pizza, but I like a lot, so that's a lot there. That's like one ladleful of sauce there. A little bit of parmesan. That really improves the flavour of the pizza. Not putting any oil in it like you see in the pizzeria, because I've already got oil in the pizza sauce. Then my mozzarella. Now this is the closest thing I can get to the mozzarella they use in New York places. So just have to make do with it.
I like a lot of cheese, so keep sprinkling it and sprinkling it. Whatever goes on the edge, I just
put on.
That'll do it.
Now, my favourite pizza topping, pepperoni. This is pizza pepperoni from Sainsbury's. Because the pepperoni you get in normal stores in the UK is far too big for me. So I just prefer this one. And I like a lot, so I'm going to put pretty much all of it on.
Now, temperature of the oven.
Normally you do it at 400. So an average household temperature is about 220, 240. So wherever you have a home, just whack it as hard as you can to get the best results.
Just spread this cheese out a bit. Actually, no, I think
one more slice of pepper will do.
Yeah, that'll do it.
Alright. Take a closer look at it before it goes in the oven.
That's that. Have a spree.
Drop it in there for about 12 to 15 minutes, and then we'll come back when it's ready. come out. Let's do this. Oh, you're excited. With the smoke. Now I just need to check something, because sometimes they get stuck in the board.
Ow.
Okay, that one, there's one bit stuck, but it won't be that a problem. The vast majority of it's stuck. Here's how you get an unstuck pizza out. Get your spatula just...
It should do that. It just
takes a little bit of cutting technique.
Oh, whatever, we'll do it later.
Let's cut into it and get some slices out. Put that back on.
Now, one problem.
Does the job just as well.
It'll be even better once you get
what are they called? When you put oil and sugar in the dough, it will brown it better like it did here. So, little tip there. Right. Pizza's all cut up. I'll serve it on the plate and we'll give it a try. Little tiny bit of the crust was stuck to it, but that's something you've got to prepare for if it happens. But you can learn from your mistake in future, so yeah. Welcome to the pizza. You know, it's not pretty serving, but it will fill your belly. So yeah, here it is, thin crust. Alright, I'm gonna give it a try.
It's really hot, but.
It's a really good effort. Look at the back as well. Pizza stone? I don't think so. So yeah, that's my pizza recipe, guys. Thank you guys for watching, and peace out. I'll see you on the next video.